Gerald, I think my record speaks for itself. I think I can look back and safely say I was right.
That's right.
I was perfectly right.
Right.
My instincts were valid and strong, right?
That's right.
When you're right, you're right.
Right.
I know when I'm right. Can you honestly say I was wrong?
Right. Wrong.
I was right.
Right.
That's right. I was perfectly right.
Right.
I was and I've been all along, right?
That's right.
When you're right, you're right. I know when I'm right. It's remarkably rare that I'm wrong, right? That's right. I mean, even in my personal life, I've always made the right decision. When I married Larry, I was 18, he was 20. We were both journalism students in Missouri, and all he wanted to be was William Allen White. I had a job on a local TV station. I was only doing the weather, but some network executive happened to see me one night. So I knew I had to go to New York, and Larry would be happier editing a newspaper in Colorado or somewhere, so it was time for a break. And though we both still cared for each other, he had to go his way, I had to go mine, so the split up was not a mistake. Now Larry's remarried and blissful out west. And I love my career. It was all for the best. I was right.
That's right.
I was perfectly right.
Right.
My instincts were valid and strong. Right.
That's right.
When you're right, you're right.
Right.
I know when I'm right. It's remarkably rare that I'm wrong. Right.
That's right.
Need we even mention my professional life? When I started doing hard news, those decisions weren't easy. I remember interviewing Nasser and saying, look, Gamal, do me a favor and do not invade Israel. But no, no, he went right ahead. Then there was Ehrlichman and Haldeman. I said, boys, you've got to tell the truth. What did they do? Lies, lies, every word that they said. Then Alexei Petrikov, the Russian dancer, said he was bored at the Bolshoi. I told him to defect, but he was too meek. Now a friend of mine just got back from Moscow, says he's frustrated, unhappy, and dancing Spartacus four times a week. Now a braggart I'm not.
Right.
But doesn't it show? My margin for error's exceedingly low. I was right.
That's right.
I was perfectly right.
Right.
My instincts were valid and strong.
That's
right.
Right.
When you're right, you're right.
Right.
I know when I'm right. It's remarkably rare that I'm wrong. Right.
That's right.
Now we have this second-rate cartoonist. My God, what's all the uproar about? Obviously, I made the right decision again. All I did was present a well-considered analysis of how the funnies are trashing the arts, and it sets off this ridiculous flap. So he creates me as a character in his puerile little strip to put Klutz or whatever the hell that cat's name is on the map. Well, when I get that publicity-grabbing, exploitive, detestable little weasel in here, well, I make him squirm. I bet I can tell you what he looks like, too. He's probably a short, Napoleonic, bald, fat, pudgy, pasty-faced worm.
Yes, sir?
Sam Craig to see Miss Harding.
Miss Harding, Mr. Sam Craig is here.
Wonderful. Please send Mr. Sam Craig in. There's only one way to treat vermin like that. I'll show him what cats are. That beady-eyed rat. Mr. Craig.
Now look, Miss Harding.
Mr. Craig, before you say anything, let me tell you something straight out. I was wrong. That's right, I was totally wrong.
No.
And not to confess would be small. That's right, when you're wrong, you're wrong. I know when I'm wrong, and you're not what I picture at all.
What?
Right, I was bad. That's right, and I must have been mad, but my bark is much worse than my bite.
Is that right?
So let's cool it, let's. I acknowledge my debts. I know. Can I buy you dinner tonight?
All right.
Terrific, what are we waiting for?
Miss Harding, you're not actually leaving now, are you?
That's right.
But it's only 5 o'clock.
Right.
And you haven't answered any of your calls yet.
That's right.
And the Senator called, and Cardinal Cook, and James Beard, and Irving Lazar, and Kurt Waldheim.
Right.
And you're going without answering any of them.
Good night, Gerald.
Mr. Craig, I appeal to you, sir. You will have her back within the hour. Right?
Wrong.
Wrong?
Wrong!